I'm Glenn Gehr. I'm a professor of psychology here at the State University of New York in New Paltz. I'm also a founding member of Move Forward New York, a local activist organization. And I'm here with my friend Ellie Kondelis, who is the president of Democracy Matters, which is a great group here at SUNY New Paltz that organized a walkout as part of the national walkout today regarding gun violence. Ellie, can you tell us a little bit about that event?
Yeah, absolutely. So there was a call today for students all across America to walk out of their class at 10 a.m. for 17 minutes to honor the 17 lives that were lost in Parkland, Florida a month ago. So we took it upon ourselves here at New Paltz to organize a walkout of our own. So we encouraged students to join us outside the Humanities Concourse at 10 a.m. this morning. We began by reading the names of the victims of the Parkland massacre, and then followed by a moment of silence to honor their lives. Then we did some chants, we got the crowd excited, and then we called our local representative and urged him to break ties with the NRA and to support common sense gun legislation.
So, as a young person, I would imagine that the Parkland situation was particularly concerning. I think it was a really upsetting situation for everyone, and unfortunately there's been a lot of situations like that in recent history in the country. But the fact that it was so unpleasant and so in your face and in a high school right now, what was your perspective as like a young person seeing what had happened?
It really affected me. As soon as I heard about it, it didn't really go away. It was all over social media. I'm sure you saw the videos. They were very graphic. And it just really hit close to home for me as a student, for someone who has been affected by gun violence in the past, and just as an American in general, because this is a fear that we live with. It's part of our everyday lives. People of my age, my generation, we've grown up wondering if one day our school might get shot up. We've practiced lockdown drills for as long as we can remember, and it's something that we've just sort of internalized. And so to see it in such detail, to hear about it the way that Parkland was discussed and displayed in the media, it was sort of a wake-up call, I think, for a lot of people my age who were kind of looking for a way to do something about this. And I think it really set a lot of things in motion, because we're done. Like, we're fed up, we don't want to deal with this anymore, and something absolutely has to change now, and that's what we're doing.
Great. And, you know, one of the things that I'm really impressed by with your group and the students that you're working with is that you're making a really strong connection between taking political action and trying to bring about change, such as making phone calls to our Congressman John Faso. How do you see those links to a student that doesn't really see the connection between political processes and the NRA and what happened in Florida? How would you put those links together?
So this is something that I try to explain and engage in discussion with a lot of my friends and people my age, because again, people my age, I found a lot are just completely feel very helpless with our current political system. They feel like their voices aren't being heard because they just see all the corruption. And they're just very upset to the point where they feel like it's better to just not engage than to do something about it. But what I'm really trying to get people to see is that the only way to create a government and an America that we want is to be involved. In terms of Parkland, if we want to talk about the NRA, Nicholas Cruz, the shooter in the Parkland massacre, was able to purchase his semi-automatic weapon that he used to kill 17 people because of very lax gun laws, which are upheld by politicians who receive ridiculous amounts of money from the NRA. And as long as they continue to receive that money from that organization, they're not going to fight for common sense gun laws. They're not going to listen to our interests, because that organization is literally writing their paychecks. So I'm really trying to make that connection with people my age, because that is something that we can change. We don't have to have those people in office if they're not supporting what we want. We can vote them out.
Yeah, absolutely. And I got to say that as someone who educates people your age and is trying to work my best to help get the next generation cognizant, awoke, and active, I got to say I'm so impressed with what you're doing, what the other students are doing. And I got to say that, to my mind, my generation has failed your generation. When you guys are having to go to lockdown drills and there's stress associated with that and these kinds of things are happening, this is a failure on our part. And it's really up to your generation with our help as best we can to get you guys back on track. So thank you so much for all this work, and look forward to what you bring to the future.
Thank you. Yeah. Hi, yeah, so my name is Mary Mitsopoulos. I am the Vice President of Peace Action, and I've been involved with them for the past year and a half. As soon as we found out that this rally was taking place, and it was just in the early ideas of it getting started, we immediately jumped on board and just wanted to get as many students involved as possible. And one of the main things that we've been focused on, along with Democracy Matters, is the registration for voter registration drive, because, you know, it's really great to have a bunch of people show up to a rally, but if they're there and they're only there for the one day, their voices are heard, but only so briefly and not in legislation. So.
Yeah.
That's what we've been focused on really heavily.
That's awesome. So as a grown-up who's pretty active in the political process, I totally see the connection between the importance of a voter registration drive and what happened in Parkland, Florida. I think it's very sophisticated for a person of your age to see those connections. So what do you say to other students who are paying less attention to the political process? What do you say to them to show them that these things are all interconnected?
I mean, the thing of it is I think the problem is so many students get discouraged or disappointed, and they feel like, I'm 18, I'm 20, how am I going to impact a politician who's been in office already for a term or two? I don't really have a full grasp on what's going on, you know? But if you're upset about something, there's legislation that can change. You know, everything that's happened in recent years with gun violence could have been prevented, and so it's so important for us to really realize that as long as we put a foot down and keep it down, it'll genuinely stop. And so for students to get registered to vote, even if they go out and vote twice and 20 of them do it, that's 40 votes, you know. It's such a big deal, and they can't function without student votes. So if we vote against, you know, John Faso partnering with the NRA, that has a real tangible impact on gun laws in New York State. And so, you know, it's a little bit of a hard leap at first, but once you grasp it, it's how this process needs to be proceeded with.
So, Mary, one of the things that we found at the walkout today, and we've seen in the days leading up to this, has been what I consider very strong support for all these events from the administration here at SUNY New Paltz. What are your thoughts on that?
I think it's really wonderful to see that the administration is supporting the students, particularly in light of this morning. I know there were a lot of instances of schools across the country that attempted to have walkouts and the students were denied that ability. So it's really positive to see that we've received that sort of feedback. That being said, I think with any issue, even on a liberal campus, there are negative responses, and we've dealt with some of that, less so from the administration. But, you know, there have been instances of club members trying to just advertise the event peacefully, and we've gotten negative comments and negative social media messages and emails from students. So it's definitely important to consider that this takes a lot out of students to organize something like this, so it's really great to have professors backing us, you know.
Yeah. That's great. And you know what? When you're on the right side of history, as you know that we are right now, it's important to just smile at the rain, as I like to say, and stay the course.
Right.
So one final question for you. I got to say, when I was your age, I was going home and watching Seinfeld and barely paying attention to what was going on. I'm so impressed with what you and your friends are doing. What do you see yourself doing into your future? What do you see yourself as your career, and how are you going to make changes in a broader sense?
Right. Well, I'm currently an anthropology major. I'm a junior here. But I intend to go to law school, and I want to engage in cultural heritage law. So basically, I guess in a totally different capacity, but still protecting rights of people and helping with reservation borders staying maintained and the preservation of important historical and artistic documents. And, you know, I just think that everybody's voice deserves to be amplified if they're speaking for a good cause. And a lot of the time, it can't get loud enough on its own. So it's sort of, if you have the ability, it is your duty to give them that voice, you know.
Wow. this is a SUNY New Paltz education right here, and this is the future. Mary, thank you so much.
Of course.
Administration. The support has been awesome. I don't know about you, but I am tired of learning about new senseless acts of gun violence in the United States on a regular basis. I don't want to hear that 17 bright young people got gunned down by a maniac in a public school on Valentine's Day with a legally purchased military-grade weapon. I'm tired of looking at charts showing that deaths resulting from gun violence in the United States are off the scale compared with any nation in the developed world. I don't want to live in a place where 30,000 people die from gunfire each year. 30,000. I'm tired of hearing politicians say that the issue is complicated, because it's not complicated, and we all know that. I've got a message for the young generation out there, and it's this. My generation has failed your generation, and I want to personally apologize for that fact. When we were kids, we did not have to go through stressful lockdown drills in schools like you do. You live with a kind of fear and stress that no one should have to live with. That is a failure on our part, and that is not okay, and we have to do better. As someone who works to develop the next generation of leaders, I do have to say that I have hope, and that I am doubling down on your generation. Because when I think of kids at New Paltz who walked out of classes today to say that they are not okay with what's going on, I have hope. When I think of the New Paltz High School senior, Caleb Sheedy, speaking to the Board of Education about the importance of today's walkout, I have hope. When I think of the amazing SUNY New Paltz students who day in and day out ask how they can make a difference in this world, I have hope. And when I think of Emma Gonzalez of Parkland, Florida, who put a United States Senator in his place in front of the world, I have hope. You are the future, and it's up to you to be the change in the world that we all desperately need right now. Years from now, people are going to look back at the gun laws in the United States of America, and they're going to shake their heads in disbelief. Look around you. Do you know who we are? We are the people who are all on the right side of history. Yeah. Don't ever forget that, and thank you. I would now like to ask my friend Beth Wilson from the UUP to say some words.
It's an honor and a privilege for me to stand here in support of the mass student-led effort to change the national conversation on guns and gun violence. On behalf of the New Paltz chapter of United University Professions, we offer our condolences to the loved ones of the victims of the Stoneman Douglas shooting, and we mourn all those who have needlessly lost their lives to gun violence. This day, marked by walkouts and rallies being staged across the nation, is only the beginning. If I have learned anything from labor history, it is that the only way those of us who are exploited and oppressed, the many who are made to suffer for the interests and the greed of a few, the only way we can counter their structural advantage is by standing together. Walking out together. Striking together. Demanding change together. It is when the many stand together that the few who are in power can be made to listen. But this has to be an ongoing effort. Today is a start, but the pressure must be maintained or this moment of opportunity will be lost. Guns are our immediate focus here, of course. But we would be mistaken if we believed that these instruments of violence were the beginning and end of the problem. We live in a violent society, a society organized around immense inequity, racism, and structural violence. Free access to guns in such an environment is simply to allow people to carry around matches to strike in a room already full of gasoline. School shootings like the one at Stoneman Douglas, or Newtown, or Columbine, or any of the dozens, unfortunately, of others are especially tragic, of course, because the students cut down there will never have the opportunity to realize the potential, the promise of their young lives. But gun violence permeates much deeper than that. Think of the scores of people of color shot by the police each year. Our objection to gun violence cannot stop at the schoolroom door. It means we must call out the presumed state monopoly on violence as well. But for those who have foolishly suggested that the way to address school shootings is to arm school employees. Fernando Castillo. He was an African-American school employee with a carry permit for a legal firearm, and despite clearly informing a police officer of that fact, he was shot dead anyway when reaching for his ID in a simple traffic stop. Imagine the tragic consequences of armed police arriving at the site of a reported school shooting with multiple armed individuals scattered through the crowd. Then imagine that happening at a school with a majority population of black and brown students and teachers. This is a recipe for disaster. More guns are not the answer. In fact, the opposite would seem to be true, particularly given the state of contemporary American culture. Working together to insist upon and then to create a more just, compassionate society is the only real path out of this madness. Yes, this will involve more time, energy, and attention than simply turning a blind eye and allowing the NRA to buy our politicians and allowing the politicians to gerrymander themselves into more secure seats. But what's the point of sharing this beautiful planet with so many beautiful, amazing, diverse people if all we can do is build walls, react out of fear, and allow them to divide and conquer us? Are we going to let that happen? We can and must demand this better world. I am heartened by the energy and the dedication of the students and young people who have called us all here today. And in the spirit of Mother Jones, and if you don't know who she is, you better look it up. Yeah. I call on us all to pray for the dead and fight like hell for the living.
I think about my cousin Chris, who 10 years ago, at the age of 18, was shot and killed at his friend's high school graduation party. I think about my youngest cousins, age 3, 7, and 9, who are growing up in a world where they are scared to go to school, and where my aunt and uncle are forced to consider the possibility that their children may one day not make it home. And I think about us as students, as community members, and as Americans, living with the quiet fear in our hearts that we might simply end up in the wrong place at the wrong time. This is our reality, and this is unacceptable. Yeah. We are fed up. We don't want to live like this anymore, and we don't have to. We are sick and tired of the excuses regurgitated over and over and over again by politicians and lawmakers who claim to represent the people. Our own representative, John Faso, took nearly $6,000 from the NRA last year. After the Parkland shooting, he sent his thoughts and prayers. Well, you know what? We don't want your thoughts and prayers. We want policy and we want change. Politicians tell us that guns aren't the problem. They tell us that people are the problem. They toss around the phrase mentally ill like it's a dirty word. So if we're going to talk about mental health reform, let's talk about real mental health reform and not use that term to further stigmatize those suffering from mental illness. And let's tell our politicians to stop using the term mentally ill as a guise for their own racism. Because if the Parkland shooter had been any race other than a white man in a Make America Great Again hat, Donald Trump would not be talking about mental health. He would be talking about terrorism. And if mental health reform is truly a priority for the president, we can start by asking him why he rolled back on Obama-era legislation that required background checks for those with mental illnesses. This is not a mental health issue. This is an easy access to military-grade assault weapons issue. Right. Yes. Our constitutional rights are not limitless. The Second Amendment is not an exception. We do not want to ban all guns. We want comprehensive background checks. We want longer waiting periods. We want genuine, lasting mental health reform. And we want a complete ban on assault weapons. We want consent. And guess what? We're gonna get what we want. We're gonna call, write, and lobby our representatives. We're gonna protest on March 24th at the March for Our Lives in New York City and in Hudson Valley. And when November comes around, we're gonna vote out every single representative who isn't with us. We're gonna vote them out.
Vote them out!
To the people of Parkland, Florida, to
domestic violence victims, to residents of crime-ridden inner cities, to the people of color whose lives are far too often overlooked, to victims of gun violence everywhere. We love you and we are so sorry this has happened to you. We are hurting with you, we are mourning with you, but above all else, we are fighting with you. Together, we will create the America that we want because we are the change that we have been waiting for.
Thank you so much, Ellie. That kid has done so much to make today happen, everyone. And now, from Keep Action, we've got Mary Fervin.
Hi, I'm speaking today as a representative of both Democracy Matters and Peace Action. Peace Action New York State believes that demilitarization is the proper vehicle for lowering gun access in America. Think back to your childhood. Imagine the simplicity of having a snack after practicing subtraction with the other kids sitting at your crayon scribbled on the table. Or think of the friends you sat with in your high school lunchroom. Or a first date to a movie theater. A nervous holding of hands and an awkward smile. These are beautiful, everyday parts of the human experience, and the innocence of them should never be shattered by the sound of fired bullets and screams. Data from the United Nations shows that the U.S. has nearly six times the gun homicide rate of Canada, more than seven times that of Sweden, and nearly 16 times that of Germany. Through mass shootings and acts of domestic violence, innocent lives that could have been saved are lost simply because of accessibility to killing machines. My mother is a first grade teacher in a school 40 minutes outside of Parkland, Florida. It could have been her school. It could have been any of ours. But it should not be this way. This does not have to be the reality in which we live. We need a comprehensive reform of our system. And in the time before we can fully reach that point, the ceasing of AR-15 sales and more thorough vetting processes can help decrease the frequency of these tragedies. To receive an education without fearing for your life should not be a privilege, but the standard by which we uphold our legislation. No classroom should ever become a battlefield. If you are upset or distraught or afraid, take that sensation and let it motivate you. Register to vote. Do your research. Show up. Let them hear your voice. Let them know that you are here and you are not going away until things are different. If every one of us picked up the phone or showed up to lobby, these laws would change. These events are tragic in a way which is beyond comprehension. But let them inspire you to fight every day until they are a thing of the past. It is within our ability to bring about the changes that will create a safe future. No more loss of innocent lives. Never again.
Hello, my name is Elias Nikichuk, and I don't actually go here, but my girlfriend does. I'm on spring break right now. So I'm from Sandy Hook, Connecticut. My brother was in third grade during the time of the shooting. He was taking the attendance down to the office as part of his morning job when the shooter busted through the glass windows in the front of the school. And my brother was shot at, but he survived. He ran down the hallway and the teacher broke the lockdown code to open her door and pull him and his partner into her classroom. And for 20 students and 6 educators, that was not the case. They were not saved. It really disappointed me and just broke my heart when I heard about Parkland, but I am so happy that people are uniting and standing up for this change because I've been doing that since December 14, 2012. It's been 5 years and nothing has been done, and the time is now. We want change!
It's been over 200 years since the Second Amendment was put in place. Since then, gun technology has changed tremendously, but our laws haven't. Why are civilians allowed to own weapons of war designed by the military with the sole purpose of killing large amounts of people? The AR-15 has been the go-to weapon of choice for so many mass shootings, including Orlando, Las Vegas, Sandy Hook, and now Parkland. For years, assault rifles were banned in the United States, but our Republican Congress failed to renew that ban in 2004. In 1996, there was a mass shooting in Australia that left 35 people dead. The shooter, of course, used an AR-15. The Australian government passed a law 12 days later restricting ownership of semi-automatic weapons, and they have not had a mass shooting since. What are we waiting for? This is the wake-up call. Things need to change now. Unfortunately, all our government can offer right now is thoughts and prayers while our elected officials sit back and take money from the NRA. Our very own president received over $30 million from the NRA during his 2016. Our own New York State representative for District 19, John Faso, took $7,915 when running in 2016. Where does he stand? Well, he is A-rated by the NRA, supports the right to own any gun, and even voted against a law that prevents mentally ill people from obtaining firearms. Donald Trump recently signed a bill rolling back that regulation. By doing just that, he is allowing for anyone to obtain assault rifles, only further increasing our chances of witnessing more school shootings. It is still legal for an 18-year-old to buy a firearm. Could they buy alcohol? No. But a gun? Yes. Florida recently passed a bill to raise the gun age from 18 to 21. But of course, the NRA does not approve. At a town hall on gun policy hosted by CNN, NRA Representative Dana Loesch was asked if she believed it should be harder for people to buy semi-automatic weapons. Her response? She said she believes the mentally ill Parkland shooter should have not been able to obtain a weapon at all. Then why did the NRA, which she represents, support Donald Trump and his belief that anyone should be able to buy a gun? And now the NRA is suing the state of Florida for raising the age to buy a gun. The NRA is suing the state of Florida because they do not want to lose their demographic of 18 to 21-year-old supporters and donors. This is a money issue. And I would just like to ask the NRA, how much are we worth to you? Well, based on the 247 students who have died in a school shooting since Columbine, and the $30 million donated to Donald Trump, comes out to about $121,470 each student. What country do we live in where an organization puts money before innocent lives? A country where guns are so ingrained in our society that we can barely pass legislation to keep people safe. Our country needs to change, not by the way it has been changing. Companies have been coming out with bulletproof backpacks, binders, and even shelters that are installed in school classrooms. Schools are spending millions of dollars to create a security system that prevents them from when the unspeakable happens. Our country will literally do anything and everything except ban guns. I'm calling on all 17 or 18-year-olds to register to vote. And anyone who is registered, please vote. It's the only way to start a revolution. We need to get the NRA-supported, money-hungry, lying politicians out of office. Yeah. It took me... Nothing will change if we just sit back and watch our world fall to pieces. This is our future, and your voice matters. Do not be afraid of standing up to someone just because they are older than you. Most power and strength comes from when someone my age has the nerve to tell off an adult. The greatest way in a democracy is education. And if the adults won't in our lives won't teach us, then we will. At the high school today, we all walked out at 10 o'clock, and I read my speech. I had a couple students read poems that they wrote, and we had about 200 students walk out today.
Thank you. Thank you to everybody who came out today to support this very important cause. Much of my words are going to echo what you already heard, especially what Caleb was just talking about. Today, we join together to remember the students whose lives were lost in Parkland, and for all the others who have been lost due to gun violence in our country. As a mother of two school-aged children, a wife of a teacher, and a school administrator myself, we must do everything possible to make sure that massacres like this do not happen again in our schools or on college campuses across America. Where do we begin? We begin by changing the laws around guns. We institute background checks. We place restrictions on who can own guns, limit the types of guns that can be purchased. We create a national registry and more. Change could be easy, but as most people agree, because most all people agree, but not the NRA. The NRA is a terrorist organization. It is trying to stifle our voices as we demand change now. They are suing the state of Florida for the recent legislation that does some of the very things that I just mentioned. The NRA doesn't even care about the views of the members it represents. Many of their own members do support sensible gun legislation. The other reality is that only 6-7% of the gun owners in the United States even belong to the NRA, yet they exert far more control over our politicians than they should. In fact, they spent over $35 million in ads to support these politicians in 2016. We must stand up to the NRA. We must stop electing the politicians who take money from the NRA. We must start here in our own congressional district where our elected official has an A rating from the NRA. The NRA spreads misinformation. The A-rated politicians will gladly reach into their deep pockets of their donors who are only concerned with their own self-interest. They will rely on fear and intolerance to mobilize their supports. They will count on us not caring enough to go out and vote. It is important that we rant and rage, share, tweet, retweet. We call our politicians, we show up at rallies, we get our message heard. We deserve to feel safe in our schools, our places of worship, our movie theaters, and at our concerts. We must stop the gun insanity that drives so many in this country. We must demand sensible gun laws throughout this nation now. We must demand change now. It is important that we donate what we can, our time, our money, but it is important that we vote. We must vote in primaries to support candidates who want responsible gun laws, and we must show up en masse in November. Our vote is our voice. It is not only our voice, but our children's voice. We do it for the voices of the millions who cannot vote, those who have been silenced, those who have been ignored, those who have been forgotten. We must vote. It is the only way. We vote, we win. Not sure if your vote matters? Look at Connor Lamb in Pennsylvania. We can make the changes that are long overdue. This is our opportunity. We cannot miss it. We must not miss it. We vote, we win. Time to use our voices, and our votes is now. Are you registered? If not, register today. We vote, we win. We must keep the momentum. We must remember the students who were murdered in Columbine, Virginia Tech, Sandy Hook, and Parkland. In November, we must show up at the polls, and we must make our voices heard. We vote, we win. Get involved, learn the facts, and show up at the polls. Turn this movement into the movement our country so desperately needs. Say it with me. We vote,
we win.
Take it away. Take it away, Tin Horn.
We vote, we win.
We vote, we win.
NRA, control our country. Background checks, background checks, background checks, checks, checks. No gun restrictions, they keep on killing. We want real gun reform right now. The NRA, control our country. Background checks, background checks, background checks.
To be, there's so much hatred, war and poverty. Oh, wake up all the teachers, time to teach a new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say. They're the ones who's coming up, and the world is in their hands. When you teach the children, teach them the very best you can. The world won't get no better if we just let it be.
We gotta change it, girl, just you and me.
Wake up all the doctors, make the old people well. They're the ones who suffer and who catch all the hair. They don't have so very long before their judgment day. So won't you make them happy before they pass away? Wake up all the builders, time to build a new land. I know we could do it if we all remember. The only thing we have to do is put it in our minds. Surely things will work out, they do it every time. The world won't get no better if we just let it be. The world won't get no better. We gotta change it, just you and me. Change it, yeah. Change it, yeah. Just you and me. Change it, yeah. Change it. Can't do it alone.
Can't do it alone.
Need some help, y'all. Y'all. Need a little help, y'all.
Yes, I do.
Need a little help.
Say it, boy.
Need some help, y'all. Change the world from what it used to be.
Yeah.
Ain't do it alone.
Ain't do it alone.
Need some help, yeah.
Need some help, yeah.
Wake up, everybody.